First, I'm going to start by working on my brows. My brows are really thick, so I'm not going to be doing much work on them. I'm just going to fill them in using this eye pencil from Davis in the shade 3. So basically what I'm doing here is to fill them in with light strokes, make sure it's properly blended out, and then I'll be defining my brows with this shade that is lighter than my skin tone. I would also like to add that if you're learning how to do your brows, I'd advise that you use foundation or concealer that is exactly your skin tone because it helps with easy blending. Right now I'm going to prime my lids with my MAC paintboard in Laying Low, and I'll be going over my crease with this brown from my Zaron Cosmetics contour kit. This is going to serve as my transition shade. And I'll be blending it out using a fluffy brush. The tape by the side of my eyes is just going to be like a guide. It's going to help prevent the shades from going past my eye area. And I'll be going in with this shade as my second transition shade, and this darker one to the outer corner of my eyelid. And I'll also be dragging it to the inner corner of my eyelid as well, and blending it out. And then I'll be going to the middle portion of my lid with this beautiful champagne color. Before I do that, I would like to spray my brush first. This just helps to pick up more product. And as always, blending out to prevent harsh lines. Right now, I'm just priming my lower lash line with the same primer from MAC. I'm going back in with the dark shade to the outer corner of my lower lash line, and also inner corner as well, leaving the middle portion for the brighter shade, that's the champagne color. Feel free to go in back and forth just to be sure everything is properly blended. Next thing I do is to line my eyes. I'll be using this eyeliner from Maybelline in charcoal black. It's okay if you're not getting a straight line. That's why the tape is there, to help us trap any excesses and create the straight line for us. Next, I'll be lining my lower lash line again with this Kajal from Maybelline, just to make my eyes pop. And now I'll be taking off the tape. I'm going to do my eyelashes, my falsies off cam, and I'll get back to you. Onto my face, first I moisturize my face. And then I color correct using this Anastasia Beverly Hills contour kit, just to cover up some tiny dark spots that I have. This look is going to be a full coverage look, so we want it to be flawless. I'm going to be priming my under eye area, the bridge of my nose, and also my chin. Feel free to prime your whole face if you have oily skin, but I have dry skin. I'm color correcting only the places that I need to. Going in with my Studio Fix Foundation MAC NW43, and I'm going to be wetting my brush so that it blends effortlessly. Feel free to use as much as you like or even use less. This foundation is buildable. But like I said, we're going for a full coverage look, so I'm going to keep building it up to my satisfaction. As you can see, it's more like I'm dabbing in the foundation. I'm not swiping, because when you swipe, you're going to create lines on your face. And I'm using this smaller brush to get to the corners that my big brush couldn't get to. I know like it seems like my foundation is a bit too light for me, but it's okay because foundations oxidize, so after some time into the day, it's going to get a lot darker than it looks now. Right now, I'm going to highlight using my MAC Select Cover Up in NC45. And as you can see, when I highlight, I like to go a little bit into my nose because by doing this, I'm already creating a slimmer nose. And this helps to reduce the work I'm going to do while when I'm going to contour my nose. So as you can see, I have big cheeks. Shout out to all the women out there with big cheeks. So I don't like to place my concealer lower than it should be because that would just make everything look bigger and kind of elongated, if that makes sense. I'm also highlighting a small portion of my forehead because I have a bigger forehead. If you have a smaller forehead, feel free to target a wider portion of your forehead. I'm also going to be highlighting my chin and the bridge of my nose and also my cupid's bow and the sides of my nose. I'll be going in again with the same brush I used to apply my foundation, just so to create a nice transition from my highlight to my foundation. I'll also be using this makeup sponge just to blend out the inner corner of my nose and just to prevent harsh lines as well. When applying your makeup, just keep blending till you're satisfied. Blending can make your makeup or break it. Next, I'm going to contour using the same contour kit from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I'm going to start from the top of my ear down to a little bit past my eyes. So I like to make the fish face by sucking in my cheeks. Instead of going, some people like to go in the hollow of their cheeks, but I like to go just above it to give my cheeks a lift. I'm also going to be contouring the sides of my face as well. While blending out my contour, I do it upwards. Because if you do it downwards, it's not going to give definition to your face. So I do it upwards and blend further with my blending sponge. While blending the top area, you want to blend into your hairline. Next, I'm going to set my highlights using my topaz and banana from Benign. I like to mix both of them because the topaz is a bit too red for me and the banana is a bit too light for me. So mixing them gives me my perfect shade. And what I'm doing is I'm just setting all the places that are highlighted. And dusting off with my powder brush. I'm also going to set the contour using this CoverGirl bronzer. And I'm doing that lightly using this palm brush as well. I'll be going over my face, just the corners of my face with this lighter brown. I'm also going to set my face using my powder from Milani. And I'm going to round everything up with my spray. This is going to help keep my makeup for a long time. And I'll also be applying some blush. I'm using this mascara from Maybelline on my lower lash. And this highlighter from my Sleek Contour Kit on my brow bone. This is just going to make it pop. Onto my lips, I always like to line my lips with my eye pencil. I always do that because I feel like it gets the job done. It doesn't matter what shade I'm using, I'm always going to use my eye pencil. Feel free to use whatever shade you want, but I'm going for a red lip. So I'm using this liquid lip stain from Stila in the shade Bizou. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. And it's okay if you get some lip stain on the corners of your mouth where it shouldn't be. You can always clean it up using some concealer. I'm going back again with this eye pencil just to make it darker and to make my lips appear smaller. I'm taking up excess using my small, the same brush I used to conceal, to highlight, sorry. And I'm going to be setting again with some powder. And that's it, I'm done with the look. I'm going to tie my gele and I'll be back. Hope you like the look and I hope this video was useful to someone out there. And until next time, stay safe. Bye bye.